Are you ready to launch your first Google search campaign in under an hour? Welcome to Google Ads Made Easy. I'm Jyll Saskin-Gales, a Google Ads coach and the founder of Inside Google Ads. I am thrilled to bring you this four-part video series completely free so you can get started on Google Ads. This is the first of four videos in this series to help you get running on Google Ads in under an hour. In this first video, I'll show you how to set up a Google Ads account and how to find your way around. In video two, we'll use Keyword Planner to pick keywords for your campaign, write your ads, and pick a budget. In video four, I'll show you step-by-step how to take those keywords, ads, and budget and implement them in Google Ads so that by the end of step three, your campaign is launched. And then in step four, I'll show you a few optional but highly recommended steps to get the best results, like setting up conversion tracking and linking other Google tools. If you happen to just land here and you're not on my website watching this video right now, I recommend going to this link. Right there, you can sign up to get this video sent to you in your inbox. I'm not going to send you anything except this video, though I think you'd like my free Google Ads newsletter as well. Let's get started, and when this video is done and you're ready to go to step two, just click the I'm finished, take me to step two button below. First, I'm going to show you how to set up a Google Ads account the right way, and then I'm going to give you a quick tour. If you already have a Google Ads account set up and you want to skip to the tour, just go to that time in this video. Let's start by going to ads.google.com. Right now, it has this yellow recommendation at the top because I already have a bunch of Google Ads accounts, but you may see something like a promotion or offer. That's fine. We are going to go to Start Now. And we are going to set up a new Google Ads account. Create your first campaign. So what is your business name? Optional, we'll call this Learn with Jyll. And what should people do after clicking your ad? You can either put your website here or you can put your phone number there. Doesn't really matter. For me, I will put learn.jyll.ca and click Next. Now it's checking some things to help me out. And this stuff is helpful, but optional. I want to focus now on getting you up and running with a Google search campaign as quickly as possible. So we are going to skip this stuff for now. Next, it is found that I have Google Analytics. So this is why when you're setting up a new Google Ads account, you want to check in the top right-hand corner and make sure you're not accidentally setting it up with your personal email address when you want it to be your business email address. If you already have things like a Google Business Profile, Google Analytics, YouTube, it's a lot easier to have all that set up under the same Google account. So now would be a good time to change that if you're not on the right Google account. For now, I'm just going to skip this part, but if your Google Analytics, the proper one shows up here, feel free to link it. Okay, now here is the part where we're going to skip, because what Google's going to try to do now is get you to create a Performance Max campaign right now. And we don't want to do that. We just want a blank account to work with. So down here, we're going to go View More Goal Types. And now, once this loads, we can actually bypass this whole campaign process. See right here, I scroll down, not ready for a campaign, set up an account only. That's what we want. Now, Google Ads is constantly changing things, so it's possible this will look a little different when you go attempt this. It'll say something maybe like start in expert mode, skip campaign creation, something that's going to let you just get an account. That's what we want. Now, these settings here are important. You cannot change your billing country, time zone, or currency later, so pay attention. For me, I'm in Canada, that's my time zone, and I'm gonna pay in Canadian dollars. If you're watching this from the UK right now, yours would default to United Kingdom, pounds, and your time zone. If you wanna change this, change it now. You cannot change it once the account has been set up. If there was some kind of offer code here, that would go there. Down here, I already have a payments profile and it already has a payment method saved for me because I use Google for a lot of things. You might need to actually enter your credit card information for the first time here. I do not want guidance. I do not want tips. And now I'm ready to submit. Let's cross our fingers. My account was created. Wonderful. So I'm going to hit continue. Advertiser verification is, again, an important step. So we're not going to focus too much on this now. We'll focus on this in step four. For now, I'll say no, I'm not an agency, because you are probably not an agency if you're watching this. And I will say yes, I pay Google Ads directly. I'm not going to verify my identity right now. We'll come back to that later. So for now, we have set up a Google Ads account. It may not seem like it, but we have. And if we go over here, we can actually go ahead and create a campaign. Once I clicked create a campaign, I then just X'd out of it to, again, trick Google Ads into just getting me here. This is where I want to be. I don't actually want to create a campaign right now. I don't actually want to do business verification right now. I have a Google Ads account. Now that we have a Google Ads account, let me give you a quick little tour. In the top right-hand corner here, that 10-digit number is your account number. So if you ever want to give access to someone for your Google Ads account, that number is going to be important. When you first open Google Ads, you will land on the overview screen. This actually isn't the most helpful screen for us though. You're going to want to go over on the left to campaigns, campaigns, and campaigns one more time. And this is where you will have your campaign view, where you'll be able to see your campaigns and see the actual performance metrics for them once you've got some campaigns in here. The date selector here is also going to be important, as that's where you'll choose what time frame you're using to analyze your ads. A few more important things you should know at this point. Over here in the goals section, this is where you're going to set up conversion tracking. We're going to come back to that in step four. Any issues with billing or completing that advertiser verification is going to happen over here in the billing section. And then under tools, planning and keyword planner, this is something we're going to use in the next video. Now you've set up a Google Ads account and you've gotten the quick tour. Let's get ready to start planning your campaign. Tap I'm finished. Take me to step two below.